Yellow Productions.
How to ride the London Underground. I'm Chris, this is Yellow Productions. I do travel guides that are fun, informative, and entertaining. And in this video, I'm gonna be telling you everything you need to know to ride the Underground, also known as the Tube. While it may seem complicated at first, after you watch this video, you'll be a pro. I've broken it down into 7 different areas. First, I'll give you a system overview, then I'll talk about planning your journey, buying tickets, getting in, finding the platform, riding the train, and then finally getting out of the station. So, here we go. The first thing to know is a system overview. The London Underground, also known as the Tube, is never known as the subway. A subway here in London is a pedestrian underpass. The London Underground is the best way to get across town or to a different neighborhood in town, though it may not be the best way to go a short distance. The Tube stations are a long way underground, so it can take you quite a ways on the escalator or walking to get to the platform, so if you're going 1 or 2 stops, you might be best off walking or taking the bus. The Tube has 270 stations. There are 12 lines which are named and colored. For example, the Central Line has also the color of red. It's the Red Line. The hours of the Tube, the trains run from 5:30 a.m. to midnight, Monday through Thursday. Friday and Saturday, it's open till 1 a.m. And Sunday, it opens a little later, 6:30 a.m., and closes a little earlier at 11:30 p.m. Rush hour in the morning is from 8 to 10 a.m., and then in the evening from 5 to 7 p.m. Those are probably times, if you can, you want to avoid the Tube. It is definitely most crowded at those hours and is also more expensive. They have peak fares and off-peak fares. There's also a few lines that offer night Tube service. Those lines run 24 hours, but only on Friday and Saturday nights. The second thing to know is about planning your journey. Before you go someplace, you gotta know where you need to go. Obviously, you could wait until you get to the station, because every station has a Tube map, but you really want to start planning before you even leave where you're standing. You can do that online. There's Tube maps. You can pick up a handy Tube map that you carry around with you, but the best way to do it is to download the City Mapper app. Yes, City Mapper. You can get it for iPhone or Android. It gives you great connections, great suggestions. It'll tell you the Tube, the bus. It'll tell you which part of the train you should be in. It'll tell you how long it takes to walk between stations. It's really great, so use that. Google Maps will work in a pinch, but the City Mapper, really a lot better. The third thing to know about riding the Tube in London is buying a ticket. And simply put, don't buy a paper ticket. They do sell paper tickets, and unless you're only gonna ride once in London, it's totally not worth it. A single one-way paper ticket is 5 great British pounds. You are best off buying an Oyster card. It's their stored value card. It costs $5 to store some value on it, and then you can use it to tap in and tap off. You buy the Oyster cards at any Tube station. They've got a whole bunch of vending machines. You just go up there, you say buy the card, and then you put exactly how much you want to load on it. The machines will take bills, coins, and credit cards, though maybe not your credit card. If you've got a foreign card, so luck on actually getting those to work. So if you're not from the UK or Europe and you don't have a chip and PIN card, then make sure you've got some cash on you to buy the Oyster card. I find if you're here for, say, 3 or 4 days, loading up about 20 pounds is pretty good. Only reason you might want to buy something on paper is if you're purchasing a travel pass. You can buy a 1-day travel pass or a week-long travel pass. It depends, in that case, how many zones you're going, how much it would cost. For shortness of this video, I won't list out the whole prices, but I'll put a link in the description below that you can look up the exact prices of the single day and the week pass to determine whether that's a better deal. I should mention one good deal about the Oyster card and the way things work here is there's a daily cap. It's basically if you ride the subway about twice, it works out to be that then every ride after that is pretty much free. So that's nice. The fourth thing to know is about getting in. Every station has ticket gates, so to get in, find the ones that have an arrow that indicates it's for entry, insert your paper ticket in the slot, or tap your Oyster card. The gates will open up. If you have an Oyster, it'll show you the balance. You could also use a contactless credit card to go through, but maybe not your credit card if you're not from the UK. Okay, once you're through the ticket gate, because you've planned your route, you know what line and direction you need to go to. Look at the overhead boards. You'll see colors and names and directions. So just head that way, likely down the escalators or some stairs. Once you get to the platform, you'll see things up on the top, some signs up on the top that'll tell you what time the next departure is and what direction and what leg or spur of the train it's going. Some lines, they're just one line, but other ones, they don't travel to all stops, they make a split. So make sure you're going on the correct split of the train to go to the stop that you want to. And while you're on the platform, make sure to stand behind the yellow line to wait. Well, when the train gets there, step to the side of the doors, let the people off, then get on the train. Make sure to mind the gap. There could be a pretty big gap between the platform and the actual train. Sometimes it can be significantly higher than the platform too, so make sure you pay attention as you step onto the train. Once you're on the train, either sit or stand. Pay attention to the priority seats for disabled or pregnant or older people. Also, if you're standing right next to the door, pay attention, the doors are curved, so watch your head. If you're tall, the doors are gonna kinda come in a little bit like this. When you're on the train, the stops are well announced in English. You can look outside the window and see the stops as well, but if you use the City Mapper app, it'll tell you exactly how many stops you have to go, so just go ahead and count. Once you've made it to your stop, it's time to get off the train. At this point, you're either gonna exit the train and transfer to another train, or you're gonna exit the station. If you're transferring, just follow the same process. Look at the overhead signs to transfer. If you're exiting, you'll be looking for signs that say way out. That's what it says, way out, usually in yellow. And then make sure you go to the correct exit. Many stations have different exits. When you get to the exit, just tap your Oyster card or insert your paper ticket to get out, and there you have it. Well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you found it useful, please hit the thumbs up button or click on this little yellow ball right here to subscribe, or click one of these other videos to watch some of the other videos from our London series. All right, thanks. Bye-bye.